Good afternoon, hip hop. Hope all is well around the world. I've taken this time because it's a very special period. It's the birthday of hip hop. And shout out to Kool Herc, who has two birthdays. Probably the only hip hop on earth that got two birthdays. His human one and the one that he started. So I want to take this time out to acknowledge some very special people. I'm writing this as a letter to Kool Herc. Shout out to Krista Glove Taylor, Egyptian Lover, Dr. Dre, Jazzy Joyce, Coco Chanel, Spinderella, Beverly Bond, Grand Wizard Theodore, Jazzy Jeff, Cash Money, DJ Toomp, Cool DJ AJ, 8-Track, Z-Trip, Sir Mix-A-Lot, Magic Mike, Q-Bert, DJ Scribbles, DJ Red Alert, Kid Capri, DJ Jam Master J, I miss you, Shortcut, DJ Clark Kent, 1 and 2, DJ Scratch, Bobcat, Easy Mike, Plastic Man, Battle Cat, Funk Flex, Disco B, Just Blaze, DJ Clue, and all the club DJs, street DJs, mix show DJs, and touring DJs. I do this in honor of you too. Please stay with me. A letter to Kool Herc is what this is. From one godfather to another, we don't speak much anymore, and that's pretty sad. So I'd like to take this time out to reintroduce myself to you, Herc, if I may. First is Grandmaster Flash. The performer, he's into the yo, what up, dope, hot, and all the good things that hip hop has contributed. And then there's Joseph Sadler, the geek, the scientist. He thinks about things like Einstein and the theory of relativity in unison. He thinks about Benjamin Banneker, inventor of the stoplight, in unison. I've been asked, describe Kool Herc. Wonderful. First DJ to publicly play grooves and breaks. Had the most incredible sound system. And this echo chamber gave him like the voice of God. But then there's a technical aspect in this role of DJs. Is possibly where I have question. Godfather, I went online to see if there were any performances of your hands doing what you do. And since I could not find it, this is what I remember, especially going to see you in Cedar Park, west side of the Bronx. Sedgwick. Now, there is question, who is the creator of this thing from a layman's perspective? Looping. When I went on Google and I looked for what I feel you did, I came up with repeat. I do hope someday that we can sit down and discuss this. Joseph Sadler would love to. There's the law of disarray. And then there's another law. When I was coming up, my father had this closet where all his vinyl lived. And as a tot, I was so perplexed and confused on how does music come out of those little tunnels. And every time I went in that closet, and he found out, every time he kicked my ass. Every time he turned around and he wasn't looking, I went back in that closet and I took them black discs with the little teeny tiny tunnels inside it, and I went to the brown box in my father's living room. I used to get my ass tore the fuck up. My father's no longer here, but in some odd sort of way, I want to say thank you to him, because as he was kicking my ass, I learned that this must be something pretty, pretty valuable of why did he keep beating me? Why did he keep hitting me while I was touching the stereo? So I did studies. When I was able to get my own vinyl, I did electronic studies on things like ohm meters, signal generators, and I learned what resistors was and what was diodes, what was AC versus DC. Because mom sent me to school, Samuel Gompers Vocational and Technical High School. So the turntable that my father used to kick my ass for, now I was able to just go touch one. I learned the inner workings, how it worked. I learned the inner workings, how the stylus worked. And I also created the piece of material that went between the platter and the record. I called it a wafer. Today it's called a slip mat. Now here's my definition of what I call looping. First DJ to put his hands on the record and using the record as a controller, as well as the sound source. I was very much hated when I came up with the system. I gotta tell you, Herc, it was so hard. I was trying to find a job doing this, and nobody would hire me. I was known for making the record dirty. I was known for rubbing the record back and forth and destroying the record. I was known for disrespecting by putting a mark on it with a crayon. And the only person that truly understood what it was that I was doing was my first prodigy. His name was Grand Wizard Theodore. You see, Herc, from where I come from looping, if you look on the screen, it's a structure, series, or process, which is the end that is connected to the beginning. That means there is no stops, there are no starts. And when I came up with this, I did this in honor of the breakdancer. I did this in honor of the two-stepper. I definitely did this in honor of the people that did that Latin dance, the hustle. You see, Herc, with this style, it spawned all these techniques behind it, like the cut, and the rub, and the scratch, and the scribble, and the transform, and the orbit, and the crabbing, and the flares. All this is done with this technique. I want to make this absolutely clear. Herc, it's only me and you left. Our third component, I haven't seen him. I don't know, but it's just us, man. I'm about peace. It is absolutely clear that you publicly play the grooves and the drum breaks first on that hot day in August. It is absolutely clear that you had the greatest sound system, absolutely clear. And it is absolutely crystal clear that you had the echo chamber first. Did I go out and buy one when I seen yours? Absolutely. Did I wish I had a sound system like you? Absolutely. But I could not. I just want to make it clear. The art of this technical thing, Herc. It's me. Now, for example, this is Herc's Discovery at Patchy. Now, what I'm gonna do is the front door and the back door, half time and double time, half time. Half time. And then I'm gonna do double time, front door. Then I'm gonna go half time, back door. Then I'm gonna go front door, red alert, you know what I'm talking about. And this time I need the tone on. Most of the time I don't. Then I take it to the top and hit it like this. This is the law of unison. It's called the quick mix theory, Herc. Took me 4.5 years to figure this out. So let's continue. There's repeat, and then there's looping. It's almost like Keep Rising to the Top by Kenny Burke or Mary Jane by Rick James. They both sound almost like each other, but they're two different songs. It's almost like Bounce, Rock, Roll, Skate by Vaughn Mason and Good Times by Chic. Close, but not quite. We can even add Another One Bites the Dust in there. Now all these two techniques are similar. They come from the minds of two different people. As the years went along, the speaker, the MC, the talker, the rapper, had a bed to speak on. They call it rap. Let's continue. Music going forward is 6 counterclockwise revolutions. Watch the line. Now watch very carefully. When I get to the right side, we're gonna start counting. That line there is the intersector. Let me set myself up on the right and I'm gonna throw it. Watch the line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, check. Watch the pink dot. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, check. You see, the tone knob becomes totally useless when you're doing the quick mix theory. And this is what separates repeating from looping. And then you speed it up. But the risk factor in it, when you speed it up, is that respect and love for you, Kool Herc. I know what you did, and I personally want to say thank you. It's my father, and it's you that helped me to do what I did. I think it's only two of us, Herc, and from this point on, we need to teach the newbies what this is. If we continue on this way, Herc, what we do will become nothing. The definition of repeating, right, is taking something, sound source, in this case, and doing it over and over again. Not necessarily being endless, but it having a beginning and an end, which means that the person on the dance floor would have to stop and start each and every time. This is what I call the law of disarray. I say this with all the love and respect, Herc, but because you didn't put your fingertips on a record and you did not have absolute control over the vinyl, so then the question is, where did I learn timing? Yes, Herc, I did learn that you had the greatest sound system and the most incredible, incredible echo chamber, and you was first to publicly play those grooves and them drum breaks. But the technical aspect of this, no, Herc, I definitely did not want to learn your technique. I went elsewhere, all due respect. So where did I learn this from? Well, let me tell you, when I finally came up with the technique, I went around looking at other DJs. But what I used to really listen is there was these mix shows, these disco mix shows on the radio in the 70s. And I would notice that although the songs they were playing were songs I wouldn't play, but they were always on time. So I want to say, in closing, Herc, happy birthday two times. Thank you so much for starting this. I definitely at this time want to give a big ups to Google. Thank you so much for this. Thank you for putting this on such a huge platform. And to my personal friend, LC Super Duper Mogul in the music business, I love you, man. And in closing, I want to say to you, Herc, we were three at one time. Now we're two. Eventually God will call and it'll be one. And then there'll be none. I don't want it to end this way. Let's break bread, chop it up alone. Or let's sit in front of press and just talk about the stories, man, because believe me, the world really wants to know. Good night.